First of all, I would like to say thank you to the ESIC team for organizing the wonderful CME. And in this topic, I will discuss about the role of therapeutic plasma exchange in COVID-19. As previously, Dr. Satyam mentioned that there is no clear-cut therapy till now available for the COVID-19. So many of the people are trying different things to treat the COVID-19 patients. So few of the people in the ward, all our ward are trying. Already tried the therapeutic plasma exchange for COVID-19. So, in introduction, the severely acute respiratory syndrome coronavirus 2 SARS-CoV-2 cause acute respiratory distress syndrome, multi-organ failure, coagulopathy, and ultimate mortality. But it was observed that the mortality or critically illness of the patient COVID-19 is not due to the SARS-CoV virus, but it is due to the maladaptive response from the patient's body itself. It is mainly, you can say this, the cytokine release syndrome or cytokine storm. It is a pathological inflammatory response at local or systematic level following infection, is thought to influence disease severity and mortality. So whenever any virus or the pathogenic organism enters into the body get the inflammatory response against that virus, but that inflammatory response also affect the host body, and that cause the cytokine release syndrome. So it increase the level of inflammatory cytokines activating the TH1 as well as the TH2 response. But in normally, usually the, although the cytotoxic T cell generally assist in attenuating viral infection, they also accelerate progression of systemic inflammatory response in COVID-19 by increasing circulating CD14 plus, CD16 plus monocyte and interleukin-6 levels. So in simple way, we can say the cytokine storm, when COVID-19 virus enters into the body in the patient's lungs alveoli, it releases the inflammatory signals. By these inflammatory signals, the dendritic cells, monocyte and macrophages are activated, and they releases the numbers of cytokines in the body, and it causes the cytokine storm. This cytokine storm ultimately leads to the acute respiratory distress syndrome, multi-organ failure, hyperinflammatory syndrome, and death of mortality of the patient. So what do therapeutic plasma exchange do in this? Therapeutic plasma exchange usually separate the plasma from patient's whole blood that contain pathological substances, which plasma is discarded and replaced by an isoenteric fluid donor plasma of 4 to 5% albumin or crystalloids. Previously, this therapy was used in patients with septic shock and multi-organ failure, as well as in previous viral outbreaks like SARS-CoV-1, H1N1 influenza, and MERS epidemic. So what is the rationale of use of TPE in COVID-19? TPE in COVID-19 patient, it removes the cytokines, which cytokines can cause the cytokine release syndrome or cytokine storm. So it ultimately block the cytokine storm. It also directly remove the viral particle more than 60 to 40 nanometer. So if we can see the COVID-19 viral particle size is 80 to 220 nanometer. So it can remove the viral particle from the body also directly, as well as it restore the hemodynamic stability of the patient. So as per American Society of for Apheresis 2019 guideline, the patient with sepsis and multiple organ failure can be treated under the category of category 3, grade 2B, in which the clear-cut evidence are not available and the decision to treat the patient can be individualized. So we can include the COVID-19 patient also under this category to treat by the therapeutic plasma exchange. The indication of therapeutic plasma exchange in COVID-19 is most likely in severe to critically ill patients, and when patient begin to exhibit the deteriorating oxygenation that might require high flow nasal oxygen or mechanical ventilation, as well as when it begin to exhibit thrombocytopenia or increase the LDH, initial sign of shock, elevated level of C-reactive proteins, increased neutrophil lymphocyte ratio, and multi-organ failures. Though there is no absolute contraindication of, to perform the TPE in COVID-19 patient, but there are many high-risk patients that we have to taken care of there in this, like coagulopathic patient, patient with DIC or receiving anticoagulants, in severely hemodynamic unstable or unable to tolerate significant fluid shift patients, A patient who unable to tolerate central lung placement, allergic to donor plasma or albumin, severely hypocalcemic patient, or received ACE inhibitor within last 24 hours. The optimal time to initiate the TPE therapy in COVID-19 patients as early as possible due to the whichever cytokines released from in the body due to in the cytokine storm, they have very short half-life. So it is better to remove them as soon as possible before they are doing the multi-organ failure or acute respiratory syndrome. So waiting until the specific marker for MOF and ARDS may present or are present may limit the efficacy of the TPE in this kind of patient. In previous studies, it was observed that TPE at 2 to 20 days after PCR positivity for SARS-CoV-2 improved clinical parameters, including PaO2/FiO2 saturation rate, C-reactive protein level, neutrophil lymphocyte ratio, and mortality. The mode of therapy TPE can be preferred alone for the treatment of this kind of patient, but it can also in conjunction with other blood purification modalities like column immunoadsorption, double volume plasma filtration, continuous plasma filtration and adsorption, multi-filtration system, continuous veno-venous hemofiltration, slow continuous ultrafiltration, artificial liver plasma exchange, adsorption and perfusion. People already tried all these combinations with therapeutic plasma exchange as well as therapeutic plasma exchange alone, or also with the other treatment option like immunoglobulin, corticosteroid, interleukin-6 receptor inhibitor, like pertuzumab and alpha adrenergic receptors. And they found the good results in combination as well as in alone. The vascular assays preferred for the TPE in this kind of patient, it can be peripheral and central, but central is preferred especially for patient with severe disease admitted in ICU and receiving multiple procedures. As well as the central line venous assays, it should be better that we can do by ultrasound guided insertion of central venous catheter to reduce the risk of vascular damage, infection, risk of medical staff by limiting the number of insertion attempts. The anticoagulation acid citrate dextrose A is the recommended. It has also the additional role in the inflammatory disease like citrate anticoagulation as potential immunosuppressive role in septic disease patient with multi-organ failure. But in some cases where the citrate is contraindicated as well as citrate is not available, then heparin alone may be considered in patient with contraindication of citrate infusion with hypoxemia, insufficient tissue perfusion, severe liver or renal dysfunction, receiving long duration TPE or LDL atherosclerosis. The replacement fluid is preferred by fresh frozen plasma, normal saline and 4-5% albumin. But COVID-19 convalescent plasma also has recommended in critical ill patient. FFP preferred to replenish the level of antithrombin third, protein C, protein S, and tissue plasminogen inhibitor due to thrombotic diathesis in COVID-19 patients. Exchange volume, it was recommended the exchanging 1 to 1.5 volume of patient plasma volume is recommended and 65% of intravascularly present toxic substances removed by this way. Number of TPE patient people in previous study they tried, they found that even with one TPE procedure, some patients were improved, but in on an average 3 to 9 procedure is yielded to desired effect. The expected outcome from TPE is improvement in those parameters that lead to the initiation of TPE, including amelioration of cytokine release syndromes. These parameters, if we can divide into the different types, the ICU parameters, we can see the SOFA score more than equal to 3 is levels to initiate the TPE. Well, when it comes down to less than 2 or equal to 2, we can stop the TPE therapy. In Apache score, if it is more than 17, it should be initiate the TPE therapy. When it comes down to less than 70, we can stop it. In respiratory parameters, we can see the PiO2 divided by FiO2. If it is value is less than 150, we should initiate this therapy, and when it jumps up to more than or equal to 150, we can stop the therapy. Oxygen saturation less than equal to 93%, we should start the therapy. When it jumps more than or equal to 98%, we should stop the therapy. In respiratory rate more than 30 per minute, we should start therapy, and less than 20 minutes, we should stop the therapy. In hematological parameters, lymphocyte count, which is normal 1.1 to 3.2 into 10 to power 9 per liter, when it jumps down less than 0.6, it should start the therapy, and it improved more than 1.1, it can stop. Neutrophil lymphocyte ratio more than equal to 3.3, we should start the therapy, and less than 3.3, we can stop it. In other biochemical parameter like C-reactive proteins, at the presentation when patient present to the hospital, if it is more than or equal to 100, we can start the therapy immediately, or it double in last 48 hours, we can start the therapy. When it comes down below 50, we can stop the therapy. LDH, when it comes more than or equal to 250, we can start the therapy, and below 250, we can stop it. Ferritin level more than 600 at the time of presentation, or more than 300 and double in past 24 hours, we can start the therapy, and it comes down less than 300, we can stop the therapy. D-dimer level more than 1, we can start, or less than 1, we can stop the therapy. In interleukin 6 level also, more than equal to 30, we can start the therapy, and less than 30, we can stop the therapy. These are the various parameters which can guide us to start the therapy, or we can count the promising results from the TPE therapy in COVID-19 patient, and we can stop it. The adverse event of the TPE in COVID-19 all are commonly, as we can see in other patients when we are doing the TPE, but it might negatively affect the immune response also, as well as the hemostasis. It removes the coagulation factors and immunoglobulins. TPE can mitigate the additional hemorrhagic and thrombotic risk in patient receiving therapeutic anticoagulations. There are many pros and cons of the TPE therapy in COVID-19 patients. Like in the pros, we can say that there are very limited number of studies which suggest us that the TPE has potential role in cytokine release syndromes, and it's likely effective in early stage of the illness, so we should start as early as possible. Other, there is no absolute contraindication of the therapy, and we can be used as an adjunctive therapy to other blood purification therapy, as well as the other treatment options for the COVID-19. It can directly remove the 60 to 40 nanometer viral particles, and FFP as a replacement food is helpful in coagulopathy. CCP can provide in patient with neutralizing antibodies, and pathogen inactivated FFP can provide additional safety in patients. So these are the pros. Cons of the therapy is only moderate to high quality of peer review evidence are available in this. We can categorize in category 3-2B, so very less promising report can be found. It is expensive and time consuming, as well as resource intensive procedures. The removing patient neutralizing antibodies from the TPE or therapeutic drug possibly delay the recovery or reduce therapeutic benefit in patients. It only beneficial in removing intravascular pre-viral particles. Using albumin or saline as a replacement food can increase risk of coagulopathy, as well as increase complication of fresh frozen plasma infusion like Trali and Teco. It may affect the inventory of FFP and CCP in the blood center. Again, the operator would need the appropriate training for PPE donning and doffing at the time of the TPE therapy, and instrument required decontamination, as well as requirement of dedicated apparatus instrument for the performing the TPE in these patients. So we can conclude that several encouraging experimental therapies are emerging for COVID-19, but there is no currently definitive cure. In that case, TPE has shown promise in the help in reduced mortality in patients with cytokine storm and sepsis, thus it is reasonable to consider it as a potential option. Therapy can be initiated and outcome determined using the critical and target level of multiple parameters. Because the safety and efficacy of TPE is uncertain, use of this therapy should be considered as on an individual basis. So this was the paper recently published by the ISBT subgroup, International Society of Blood Transfusion, for the guidance and practices of the TPE in COVID-19 patients. Thank you.